going to the cross. Where is the one?
One all at half time.
Yeah, I saw the first bit.
Just caught the news.
Yeah. It was a bit sluggish actually, Liverpool. Don't know what was going into it.
I just find you in the network.
Well, actually, what you could do is, for some reason, John gave you, you signed the minutes for last month, but what you signed was the agenda.
Oh, that's brilliant.
I was like, why aren't the minutes signed? And John said, I gave you the prize. I'm like, no.
What?
You gave me the agenda to sign. Did you sign the minutes for last month?
Give me the agenda to sign.
From last month.
From last month, yeah. From October. So.
Yeah, go ahead.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Should I put today's date on there?
No, there's some trouble, I think you'll be, yeah, you can leave it blank, or you can put the 27th of November.
Hold on,
I went out, I chipped in and popped into Albion,
I saw that. 27th of
November.
27th of November. I saw that, and I'll get it
over. Cheaper than Tesco's.
Very.
I thought, well, I'll get some. And,
good move.
Thank you. I think it's nice to have
biscuits with. I also think it's nice.
I hope you can buy them.
I can resist anything except temptation.
So your wife in the car.
Well, that's John that she did it for you. Really?
Tesco's Express. Yeah. I didn't see you, but I saw your wife in the car.
Oh, no, I just popped in and got a paper.
I thought we'd get that one out.
He was very good. Right. Tom? Oh, we're starting with you, Tom. Okay. Oh, everyone else sitting comfortably? Okay, we'll begin then. Okay. Welcome introductions. Emergency evacuation procedures, you know what else? Out for that door or out there. In the car park. If there's still been recording me saying, we've done that. Submissions from the public, I think we've done that. We'll be there. Receive any apologies for absence?
Yes, councillors Terry Callan and Andy Walk.
Okay. Okay. Right, any decorations by members and the local government? 1962. For the chair, Star Wars is coming out tomorrow, locally, at the View Cinema, 7/19th, and go and enjoy.
Star Wars, they made another one.
Yeah.
And they're opening the theme park.
I could be there tomorrow, like 3 days. Absolutely. With
I didn't realise they made another one. No, brilliant.
Yeah,
it was advertised last year.
Put that into the minutes.
Yeah, please put it in a minute.
So you can admit my bit, that I didn't realise they made no Star Wars.
And I'm sorry for all the public that missed that announcement, they may miss Star Wars, so there it is.
And also in Florida, they've got the thrill ride
for Star Wars. A Star Wars thrill ride?
Yes.
Well, I'd like to go on that. So perhaps I wouldn't. right. Confirm the minutes of the meeting, 27th of November, is the current record. Yes. Okay, so I'm going to go through it. Page one,
yeah.
Page two, three.
What have you been drinking?
Me? Coffee.
I think you'll stick to tea.
Right, is everything okay on that? Nobody objections to that or anything?
Okay. Proposer, please, my seconder.
Have you had a proposer, have they?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got a seconder. Okay, I'll kick him a bit on that piece. His hands going up there. Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keith, are you abstaining?
Yeah, again.
Not there.
Right, could you initial every page and sign and date the last page, please?
Okay.
He's never been there, have you?
Thank you.
But not the agenda, Brian.
We're in there.
We're going to get through
this. I'm not giving him the agenda.
We're going to have a party.
I see the agenda signed.
6, I always discuss this time. Right, so consider any matters arising from the minutes of the meeting on the 27th of November not covered elsewhere on the agenda.
Just an update on the planning appeal regarding the Willowbrook Centre.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Well, I don't have an update. The update is that...
The update's...
There is no update.
Well, I can give you an update. Everyone's surprised that South Cross at the end actually finished it.
Because I thought, I heard that it was being delayed because of the election.
Well, yeah, you might have heard right then.
But then I would have thought, if that was the case, then last Friday or this Monday, they would have given the result. So
but
it just seems a bit strange that...
You might have heard that, but the reality is Perder actually doesn't affect... I would have thought inspectors, because planning is a bit different than that.
Yeah.
And in reality, even during the Perda period, although we might actually say that certain councillors actually vote in a particular political manner, it's new elections, we still actually have to do the things.
It
shouldn't be that, but I can understand someone saying that. But you know, it has been said that they can't be in the same way as they can be, because they can't redesign. They can't actually look at anything that has already not been looked at, because they submit an appeal based on the things that has gone in, and the way that the officers actually look at it. Because the officers were actually saying, yes, we want to do it. You know, it's fine. It's not a problem. And then it's very difficult for them to defend the position of the councillors when they say, no, it's not. But he did eventually come behind the councillors on it. Whether or not it was too late, I don't know.
Well, I can understand Perda if it was like for locals, but it was the general election, so it shouldn't really affect council.
That might not be, that was just what I had heard,
which
somebody said. It was delayed because of Perda, but I'm not sure that's right, because we still haven't had the decision.
Some people.
Well, perhaps somebody there thought they weren't considered to win the election, so that they announce it. It's being pushed out.
Planning is part of government, isn't it?
Yeah. But it shouldn't affect that, should it?
It should not.
No, the process should go on and be behind the scenes, but they wouldn't be able to make a major policy announcement.
Sometimes you forget the government minister who is in charge of all the planning, Secretary of State. And what he could do is, if an inspector did the wrong, you know, if he felt that should be called in that decision, he can then call it in. So perhaps they are going to do something a bit naughty.
Yes, he could call it in, but he couldn't then make the decision.
Well, no, the inspector can, the Secretary of State can actually return the decision of the, he's the most powerful.
But I don't think he would do it until the election was over.
So it could be, if we're looking at that scenario, then it could well be that the officer is deciding to, well, the inspector is deciding to go along with the original application. I can't wait to get my McDonald's there, so let's see. I came out of here the other night and I was absolutely famished, and I said, yeah, Sarah, I really could have gone out there and got McDonald's. Driving up to cribs, never mind. Okay, so we've done that. Seven, to note the outcome of previous planning applications and other documents pertaining to planning and environmental issues. And I'll hand you on to.
Okay, you have that tabled. There are 9 decisions, 4 of which are going to be a power decision, which is a bit sad, really, this time.
That's what I was thinking.
Four of them. Oak tree. That's what we're doing.
Such a long time, isn't it?
Which one's that? That by Toby? There was
no, we've bought you.
Oh, the Winterval one, yeah. Because weren't they going to build one of...
There was a planning application,
We did put it through, we put conditions on, and they were quite happy with conditions, and the guy that owns the building rang me up, in actual fact. They really wanted to get on with it and do a good job. What they came back with, I think, is in excess of what everybody expected, so that's really good. And they actually haven't got the canals for the conditions. No water taxes.
In the original one,
what they did, they copied somebody's plan to get there, and they forgot to leave the water taxes out.
In the travel plan, it said water taxes.
Which Sharon actually noticed, which I managed to bring up on planning, and everybody laughed at it. Because she'd read the document. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Next, yeah. Okay, prepare responses for the storage of the coming location there from the budget.
Yeah.
Thank
you. Get a fee for that.
I expect
a
charge.
You have
it
tabled, so there are four, there's one more than there were. So the first one, P19-17706F, demolition of existing conservatory, erection of two-storey and single-storey rear extension to provide additional living accommodation. So this planning permission was actually granted under P19-6756F, and council didn't have any objection to it, and they've now put in a revised planning application. So it's slightly smaller scale than it was. So it's this house here. Let's get rid of that conservatory and to build across. It's been in the system for a long while. There's no comments from any of the neighbours or anything. So didn't download from the South Gloss website, but I do actually have the diagram here. It was proposed for it to come right the way across there. Look on there. Mm-hmm. They wanted to come right the way out, but they've actually set it back a bit now, so it doesn't come out as far. So it was going right the way to there and there. Yeah, so it's set back a bit.
Yeah, move it.
I guarantee that although the planning officer basically just said a little quiet word to them.
Yeah.
Because you do like a step back.
Keith
proposed and Tom seconded. Can you vote on that,
please?
Yes, yeah, if we agree with the larger one, it's fine. We'll get the smaller one.
That's true. Do I say that is one? Have a chat there.
Okay, so the next one is 71 Stanshaw's Close, P19-17760PR. So there are masses of
plans
for this. So it is actually...
So we've got to play off that existing conservatory seat, that would be quite spectacular, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
A roof light, yeah.
Oh, roof light is much better than
that. Oh no, it's awful, isn't it?
How come this master plan is from one concession, one front and one...
So it's this one on the end here.
Is it going like a hind?
And I can show you... I can't show you the back street view, but I can show you the street view. This one here.
Mm-hmm.
So it's to put in one front and one rear roof light.
So they're putting a bedroom in the attic in effect.
So
why do they have to put all those plans in? We don't understand that.
It's a roof light, not a door light, is that right?
If I show you, so the so that's what's there at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what they want to put in. So they're going from that to that.
Okay,
that's right,
isn't it? It's better than a dormer.
Yeah.
They'd have to stand on a chair, look down.
Yeah. Because the dormers, they stick out, don't they?
Mm. Well, you've got to put the application in because when it's at the front, basically, if it's at the back, we don't have to bother.
There's no comments from neighbours on
that. No problem.
Agree that.
Yeah. It's a shame you've got to go to all that trouble to have put that in just to do that. It's crazy.
Yep.
Is that
move.
Keith? And then Michael seconded,
yes.
Think.
Yeah, happy Christmas, 51 Oakley Crescent.
Can you take a vote on that, please?
They sent a Christmas card saying that the Bradley State and Council unanimously agreed with the application having Christmas.
And we're sorry about the tree they had to kill for all the useless.
Right.
Next one.
Next.
Second.
Quite a few people have done the Jubilee.
This is the 51 Oak Tree Crescent, which is erection of a single storey rear conservatory.
Right.
So let me just close these and get a bit confused. So it is.
The Oak Crescent is the one.
This one here.
Mm-hmm.
Single-storey rear conservatory. There's a neighbour comment on there. I guess they get on well with their neighbour.
Mm.
You see the comment?
No.
Yeah.
More
happy conservatory.
Oh,
yeah, move it, Chair.
Before we do that, I'd like to ask Keith.
Do you just
want to
have a
question.
Look at it a second?
I'd like to ask Keith a question. Keith, have you ever seen a two-storey single rear conservatory?
I see one on the 13th floor of a block of flats.
Really?
Yeah.
But it was still a single story though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So
you wouldn't
it
believe it.
What? So going from that
somebody
from
who wanted a conservatory on every floor of a block of flats called Nelson Mandela House.
That was proposed by
Pete. Think
about
it.
Something like that. Okay, both points on.
Cowboy.
Seconded.
No objection.
No objection.
Who seconded?
Michael, you propose that, please.
Thank you very much.
And the lock
conversion
would
jump
away.
46
right away.
Is there another one?
Yeah.
Another
one. Lock conversion. Yeah.
So this is a certificate of lawfulness, so they are basically saying they want South Gloss to confirm that they don't need a planning application to do the work because
it's been approved.
They've not done it yet, but the planning officer has said that it doesn't need it in their pre-application advice, so
okay.
So I will show you. So it is this one here.
This is
I assume it's still down the road from St Mary's, Tom.
Yeah, that's the
we can do the back, is it?
Well, this is the bit is all to show you what it is.
Quite
from that.
Yeah. Can't see much of
the
lock
front.
Yeah,
no, that's as good as I could get on Google Earth, I'm afraid.
Okay.
So
I can
show you
problem,
on the application form. If you look down the application form, pre-application advice. Sort and it said the proposal is considered to be permitted development.
Where's the window in the back? Is it? Yeah.
So they're not coming out, they're literally just converting the loft so that they're just roof lights there.
They're quite
no, no objection.
They are very large spaces up on those hanging sections.
Yeah, move it.
No objection. That was my thought, seconded by Keith.
No.
We've got that piece.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, give some happy Christmas cards to all of you.
Thank you very much.
Here's someone. As the mayor,
send them
happy Christmas. Responses are all okay then.
Yeah, well.
That's got to be record, isn't it?
Weight limits, including Braden Avenue and those round Gypsy Patch Lane. So trading standards and the police will be undertaking two joint operations a week from the new year, checking vehicles are not breaching weight limits. These operations will be targeted at times and places where the intelligence suggests are most likely to be affected. Initially the police will issue fixed penalty notices, but there will be an option for a trading standard prosecution if the circumstances or severity of breach, repeat breach, warranted. Trading standards are happy to receive intelligence on potential breaches, but to make this manageable, they need to be emailed to trading.standards@southgloss.gov.uk, detailing days, times, locations, and any branding or identification marks on the vehicles. This information will be added to the rest of the information intelligence and will help to inform future operations.
Mm-hmm.
Due to resource constraints, responses to these will be limited to the information being reviewed by officers. And then under enforcement, the CPME project team have confirmed all local transport operators as well as the Freight Transport Association and Road Haulage Association are on the project mailing list and have been receiving all updates regarding the CPME project. This will continue over the coming months, so they will be aware of the impending road closure and signed diversion.
Mm. Not totally aware of the subject.
Keith, do you want to give me an update? Because Shannon goes to the previous.
I mean,
this one I know you've got there.
Trading standards, they need to be there at 2:30 in the morning, like last night, and a massive lorry there. And they decided that it's going to turn around and drop some drive, and drop something off and then go back.
So but I guess if you personally, if you saw it reports it, then they will go out and
then they'll go out. No. I mean, obviously, they're going to do the daytime enforcements. It'll be whenever the police beat team officers are available, when trading standards are available. They've got the info. I mean, I feed them through when I see the lorries, and I give them the photographs of them where possible as well. They've got that. And they chase the companies and tell them their driver was seen at a certain time, and then they deny it, and then they get it in, and then they find it was a Tesco lorry or something like this. You know, it's whistling to the wind, really. The bridge will fall down one day. That's it.
Yeah.
Then you can get rid of it.
Yeah.
And won't be a weak bridge to worry about then. But the other one, Sharon, have you got the one about the, they brought the pile driving forward?
No.
Yeah, they're going to do the pile driving. I think they were doing some last weekend, and I think they're going to do some this weekend. They're trying to get it in while the weather is reasonable, rather than wait until January when the weather is probably not.
Yeah, I saw something on Facebook about
that. That's right, yeah. But along with that, there is parking obviously going on in the Labour, around the Brook Avenue, in the pub.
It's a sample of what they're going to get, isn't it?
Yeah. And of course, there is the issue with the trees. That's going to carry on, you know, and to take out all those healthy, you know, undiseased trees is absolutely criminal. And put nothing back, well, awful for the residents.
Why did they put it down, those trees down by Gypsy Patch Lane roundabout, where they've got their green things, and put trees there instead of these green
What they're saying is that they're going to take all those trees out, and they will replace the tree somewhere else. It could be in Vibe Green, it could be in Emerson's Green, it could be in Warmley, it could be anywhere. They're going to put some trees back, but not where they should go. When the road's realigned, give the residents some trees back, you know.
Well, there's plenty of...
We're not bothered with the bus lane at all. It's only a small bus lane. Is it really needed? The bridge will be widened. They need, you know, lower the road. They needn't do anything to that road, really.
Mm. Actually, you've always liked this scheme, haven't you? But you wouldn't interfere with
that. Yeah, I mean, the bridge
we want this bridge widened.
The bridge is a win-win. There's no argument on
that.
But it's what they're going to do with the road and the trees and all those residents. Nothing between their houses and their traffic.
We didn't think we were going to lose our trees, did we? Right,
no,
9.2.
I have no doubt the traffic will be bigger.
Yeah, 9.2. So, new TPO, we are actually looking... Well, someone's looking to save a tree, but then again, it might be just putting the CPO and then changing it for you.
So actually, it is the trees up by where the old office used to be at Woodlands.
Cortland.
So if you have a look on this diagram here, which is in the middle of the industrial estates, it's literally trees around the edges.
On the back of that corner.
It's good having trees anyway, because you've got the motorway, you've got all the carbon stuff coming off in this block.
There it is.
You'll
thank you, Michael.
Take all those out of our way.
Quite
good if
they want to protect the trees
in
the industrial area.
Yes, sir. But it just becomes completely stark and it's concrete and brick, always.
It's nice to be able to watch like birds and squirrels and things.
Yeah.
Sharon's very lucky because she commutes from here to a beach. Don't you every day?
Yes,
until it
snows. Until it snows, then I'm not lucky then, I'm stuck.
And she can see what she can't get out.
I can't even get out my driver.
She was
a couple of meters where they put the coffee bar on.
So
can
you have no objection?
Yeah, it was that way.
No objection?
I thought it was the people.
Can we have a proposal and a second?
Proposal and a second?
I'll second.
Thank you.
Good, please.
Lovely, thank you very much.
Right, deal with matters relating to health and safety. Can I put a health and safety report?
Right, you have that in your agenda pack. Apart from the CCTV on the side of the container, which was reported by residents in the police department, and the base camera.
Do you have insurance told or
not? No, it wasn't.
Is that the new family, is it?
Pardon?
Is that the new family?
That was a younger person who was sitting on top of the container and picked it off. I thought it was very funny, apparently, until it was pointed out to them that what they were doing was being recorded by another CCTV camera. It fell along, so. So the Rosemary Close play area gate was vandalised, and we have had an insurance payout on that. So that was good. And then obviously there was just the next forthcoming project will be available for the play area. So we have the orders that have been placed, and then there's just one accident, which was a member of the public slipped at the baby's court. But the inside, because they're very wet there.
Have you any feedback on the images? And the images are quite really good for
you. Oh, what you mean for the criminal damage?
Yeah.
Yeah, the police know who it was.
That's good.
Might do anything about it.
Any prosecution?
sanctuary?
I don't know.
Well, they're ashamed, really. It's a
happy to propose acceptance of the report and a vote of thanks.
That would be lovely, vote of thanks and acceptance.
Yes, I think it's
interest.
Ben,
Thomas
seconded. And Yeah. It's a phrase of training. What do you call a phrase of feels training?
Because it's really useful stuff. So it's things like sanders and saws.
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah.
It does sound a bit bizarre. There's no bills and direct debits because obviously we've just done that in finance. Wait for the next meeting.
Hey, the next meeting is at January 7 PM and we've got OTL coming in as well.
We
so that will be a little treat for everybody.
That would be good.
OTL from
the arena.
To tell us what's happening there. They put their permissions in, applications in, to tell us to see what sort of applications come in. They also put an application for,
right.
Chief Attempting Price Park, where the park and ride. Like Chief
Good training, can you go fishing then?
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Thank you.